The Amusement Park, 1973. This was billed as a horror film, but it's not actually a horror film. That being said, when it was filmed in 1973, they didn't think audiences would be able to watch this film without being overly disturbed, so it was not released. And it waited quite some time before it was seen by the public eye. That being 2021. It did actually air in some theaters, I'm told, but it was really not released widely. It's interesting to note that literally everyone you see in this movie is a volunteer and not a paid actor or actress. They are volunteering to be there for the statement that the movie is making. This statement is a very profound statement about how society throws away old people and the disabled and people with disability and whatnot stuff. It focuses heavily on specifically the elderly, and in specific, the elderly who don't have a lot of money. So it's a very powerful statement, but the way it is filmed, it is unsettling, to say the least. It gives off this really creepy vibe. It's an incredibly good statement. It's very true. It deals with an enormous amount of symbolism instead of just out saying things. But it's one of the best movies I've ever seen, nonetheless. So, yeah, I gave it a 9 out of 10. Vicious Fun 2020. This is a different one. It's kind of one of your lower budget movies, although it's not a bottom line type movie. You'll probably never see any of these people in anything else unless you watch B-rate movies like this. But it was fabulously fun, and there's a throw to a whack of horror movies and serial killer movies and stuff like that. The dude follows somebody who was dating his roommate to see what he's about, and long story short, he ends up in a room with a bunch of serial killers. They find out he's not one of them. They end up hunting him, and it's there's a lot of blood, there's a lot of violence, but it's very 1980s type thing, because it's actually set in the 1980s, and it's really quite a fun movie. The one major part about this is the strong female lead is a serial killer who kills serial killers. Yeah, I liked it. It was fun. It was really fun. 8 out of 10. Death Ship, 1980. What can I say? This is not a classic movie, although I've seen it a bunch of times. It is a very, very B-rate movie. That being said, I gave it a 6 out of 10 instead of, like a 2 or a 3, like some people have, I'm sure. the plot here is that a haunted ship rams a cruise liner and sinks it. Some of the survivors end up on the damned boat, which is a Nazi torture ship, they come to find out. And it goes kind of south from there. There's a lot of happenings, and the captain gets possessed and things like that. And it's okay. And it's fun to mock because it is done so terribly badly, which is interesting because there's a couple of actual big name actors in this one. So yeah, anyways, they tried with this one, that's for sure. It's better than Towering Inferno, but